the history of our democracy, no MP has served as MP of Thiruvananthapuram for longer than 12 years. That was my distinguished predecessor, Mr. Charles, had three terms, but one was a two-year term. So he only served 12 years as MP. So if indeed all goes well and I'm able to serve out a full term, I will be the longest serving MP of Thiruvananthapuram ever, which is quite a feeling for somebody who came into politics so late in life after a full career at the United Nations. And I must say that I've taken to the people of Thiruvananthapuram and they have welcomed me with open arms. I'm very grateful for the trust they have again reposed in me, and I intend very much to live up to that trust and serve them to the best of my ability in the next few years. I have a number of ideas and I'm going to hit the ground running as soon as I can to make sure that Thiruvananthapuram is well represented in Parliament and at the national level.
Sir, what are the favourable factors for you and also for UDM?
Well, you know, we've had an extraordinary result in Kerala. I think since 1977, we've never had such a good result, in which we have won 19 seats and the 20th is still too close to call. We might even win all 20 seats in the state. That's extraordinary. So it really has been an amazing, amazing performance by the UDF, and I think we must credit the values of the Congress Party and the UDF: secularism, inclusivity, social justice, economic growth that is balanced and that serves the interests of the poor. All of these values are the values of Kerala. And I think in many ways we have become the exemplar, this state has become the exemplar of what the politics of the Congress nationally could be. I just hope that we will be able to rebuild from the very disappointing result